tú que kuabudu, tú que kuinua, kuakua wewe unastahili, na hakuna aliye kama wewe. Asante mfalme wa ajabu, tuko mbele zako, tuko madhabahuni pako, tuko katika uwepo wako, tukikushukuru, tukikukaribisha, ukanene nasi, ukaendelee kutuhudumia kadri ya mapenzi yako. Hatuwezi bila wewe, nami najitenda kwako kama chombo, unitumie kama jinsi upendavyo. Sina langu la kuwaambia ila lile ambalo umeweka ndani yangu, ukanitumie ulioachilia kadri ya mapenzi yako. Twakushukuru kwa kuinua, tukisema ni asante. Katika jina la Yesu tumeomba na kushukuru. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We thank God this evening. We are grateful that the Lord has been good. He has kept us safe and he has given us the grace even to come this far. It is not by power, not by might, but by your spirit. And we thank God because this far, he is Ebenezer. I welcome you to this midweek service. We are going to have a wonderful time. It is a new month. It is we are in the second month of the year, and I bless the Lord that he has been gracious to us through the month of January. We had a lot of victory and a harvest of miracles in the first month when we were going through prayers and fasting. And God is good, and his mercies endure forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Those that he has redeemed from the hearts of the hunter, and I'm one of them. My name is Dorcas Nyambura Mwangi. I am born again. I am, by the grace of God, a daughter of this ministry, of this church, and Reverend Ann Wachiko, and I am blessed to eat from this altar. We are going to share a message entitled Counting the Cost. Kuhesabu Gharama, Counting the Cost. And in every perspective of life, ama katika maisha, kuna mahali, kila mahali, karibu kila mahali, inatakikana tuhesabu gharama. Every decision that we take, every step that we undertake, or every task that we undertake to do or to accomplish, it calls for us to do a certain thing for us to get to where we want. And it is also on the same note that we are going to share very briefly about certain aspects of life and related to our spiritual walk. Praise the name of the living God. And I would like us to think, in as much as we want to control our lives, in as much as we normally say, this is my life, let me be, let me do whatever I want, especially when it comes to youth, our youth, we want to be left to do our own things. We want the freedom that we never had, maybe when we were in primary, in high school. Now we want to explore the world. We want to do so many things without somebody having to ask us anything. And now when we narrow down to our Christian walk, Jesus illustrated in the book of Luke chapter 14. Quickly, let us go there. The book of Luke chapter 14 from verse 28. Luka 14 kutoka mstari wa 28 mpaka wa 33. Luke 14:28-33. Starting from, let's start from verse 26. Luke 14 from verse 26. The Bible says this is Jesus who was speaking to the many people who are following him, both the disciples and the multitude. If you want to be my follower, you must love me more than your own father and mother, your wife and children, brothers and sisters. Yes, more than your own life. Otherwise, you cannot be my disciple. And you cannot be my disciple. And you cannot be my disciple if you do not carry your cross and follow me. Yesu akawa hata kama alikuwa anatembea, anafanya miujiza, anaponya watu, na anakuwa na wakati wa kuomba, usiku alikuwa anakesha peke yake, na unapata watu walikuwa wanamfuata sana wakijiuliza ni nini huyu jamaa. Hata kama wengine hawako wameshika ya kwamba na ufunuo ya kwamba yeye ndio ule Mesia alikuwa ametabiriwa in the Old Testament by so many prophets, walikuwa wanajiuliza hizi nguvu ambazo huyu Yesu anatembea nazo ni zinatoka wapi. Na this time he was explaining to them that there is a condition for you to be my disciple, for you to follow me, you have to carry your cross. And akawaambia hapo chini ya kwamba if you do not carry your cross, you are disqualified. Praise the name of the living God. Let's continue to verse 28. But don't begin until you count the cost. And that is the core of my message this evening. Don't begin until you count the cost. For who would begin construction of a building without first getting estimates and then checking to see if there is enough money to pay the bills? Otherwise, you might complete only the foundation before running out of funds, and then how everyone would laugh at you. They would say, there is a person who started that building and ran out of money before it was finished. So, you see that there are people who are going to watch this person. When you start something and you leave it midway, then people are going to laugh at you. Just like when somebody starts a building and they are not able to complete it somewhere along the way, then when it rains and the sun shines on the same building, especially with our stone buildings, you find that the building starts to deteriorate. Unapata inapasuka pasuka katikati kwa sababu yule mtu alikuwa anajenga hakufanya hesabu, hakuangalia gharama ni gani ili nikaweze nikianza nitamalizia bure ile kazi ambayo nimeanzia, ile kazi nimeweka hata pesa nyingi kwa foundation, nitakwama katikati na nibaki kuchekwa. So hata afadhali sijaanzia. And so on what king would ever dream, that is Luke 14:1, or what king would ever dream of going to war without first sitting down with his counselors and discussing whether his army of 10 then while the enemy is still far away, he will send a delegation to discuss terms of peace. So no one can become my disciple without giving up everything for me. Praise the name of the living God. Jesus is continuing to illustrate that this king, what kind of a king can start, can engage in war without first seeing how many people, how many army officers do I have? Who can be, and what about my enemy? What does the other, my counterpart have? If my counterpart has more, as more other guys, they are more armed, then that king sits down with his counselors and then he organizes who will go to a delegation, who will go and meet the other king and also agree on terms of peace. We saw in our nation some times back when there was a lot of post-election violence. And many people are losing their lives. People's houses were being burned. There was a lot of chaos in our nation. And we saw it came to a time that we just did not need our own people around. We needed somebody from outside, somebody with an independent mind, somebody who was neutral to come and talk to them, our political leaders, the ones who had some conflict or some differences amongst themselves. And so when they came together under the authority and under the guidance of this neutral person by the name of Kofi Annan, then these two leaders were able to come together and agree on some terms of service. This is how we are going to walk along, so that these people can stop fighting. These people now can live in harmony. So in our spiritual walk, we also have to count the cost, because the work of the cross, the redemption that we got through the dying on the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, is not free. This, our salvation is not free. Tumenunuliwa kwa gharama. We were bought at a price. That is why we need to magnify God, glorify God with our bodies. Because we belong to God. And so when we come to Christ, we have to know that one leg should not be in the world while the other leg is in the kingdom of God, because we cannot have both. Praise the name of the living God. And Jesus said, you cannot have God and mammon. One supersedes the other. Ile gharama ambayo Yesu alilipa, pia sisi tukiwa wa Kristo, inatubidi tulipe kwa kubeba msalaba. Msalaba si rahisi. And that is why we have to keep on having fellowship with one another. And as we have fellowship with one another, we call on the Lord, we call on the Holy Ghost, we call on the Holy Spirit, because He's our helper. When we have fellowship with Him, then we will understand the mind of God. Then we are able to know, for me to be able to be the disciple that Christ needs in His kingdom, then I have to say goodbye to 1, 2, 3. Praise the name of the living God. And so, brothers and my sisters, we have a cost. We have to sit down and we have to write down, what do I need? Do I need to leave my parents? Sometimes it will call for us to leave some of our best hobbies, whatever we love doing so much. Like in the month of January, by the grace of God, We had to forget Ugali. We had to forget Kamaembe, Kidogo. Ilibidi tusahau chapati, ambazo tulijienjoy over Christmas. Because we needed to align ourselves. We needed to sacrifice for our destiny. We needed to sacrifice so that we can get God's direction for the year 2021 and even beyond. And during that time, when we are denied the fresh, then we are investing in our spirit. We are investing in our inner man. Kwa hivyo, mtu wetu wa ndani, asikae amestaafu, asikae njaa. Tusinone tu kimwili na kiroho mtu wetu amepona. Praise the name of the living God. Because it is what will profit a man if we gain the whole world and lose our souls. Praise the name of the Lord. So for us not to lose our souls, kuna gharama, ndugu yangu. Kuna gharama, gharama dada yangu. Praise the name of the living God. And everything that we do in the kingdom of God, through prayers, through obedience to the word of God, reading the word of God, encouraging one another, our service to God, our service to one another, sharing and all that, is a great investment. It's part of the cost we have to pay. Because Christ, when he was on the cross, alisema, it is finished. Imekwisha. Na diwaka, alisurubiwa kama amekaa hivi. Imekwisha. Yote imekwisha. In fact, imagine, he had to die naked. Because even his own clothes, nguo zake, waligawa, mpaka ikabidi wapigie kura. Praise the name of the living God. Kama nguo ya Yesu, vazi la Yesu, akifa msalabani, linapigiwa kura. My friend. Safari ya wokovu. Ili tufikie hatima ambayo Yesu ametuwekea, inabidi tugaramike. Praise the name of the living God. Na ndio maana Yesu akasema, mtu akikuomba koti lako, mpe hata na shati. As in, you don't withhold. Our culture as believers is not to withhold. Sisi kwa kushikiria kitu ambacho tunafaa kuachilia. Praise the name of the living God. In fact, as we continue to taona, anasema mpaka tunapo toa yote kwake. Then, it is until we release our lives that we are able to gain it. Hatuwezi kushikiria maisha yetu hivi na tukayapata huko mbele. Itabidi tuyaachilie kwake ili aitumie tuipate. Praise the name of the living God. Praise the name of the living God. Let us quickly go to Matthew chapter 16. Mathayo sura ya 16. Matthew 16 from verse 24. Matthew 16, 24. Hallelujah. Matthew 16, 24. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if any of you want to be my follower, you must put aside your selfish ambition. Shoulder your cross and follow me. If you try to keep your life for yourself, you will lose it. But if you give up your life for me, you will find true life. 16, and how do you benefit? Do you benefit if you gain the whole world but lose your own soul in the process? Is anything worth more than your soul? Praise the name of the living God. And you see, there is a putting aside so that you can gain. One man once said, I can't remember his name, that He's not a fool. He's not a fool. One who gives what he cannot give to gain what he cannot lose. Ya kwamba, kuna yule mtu, awachiliaye, kile ambacho hawezi hifadhi, ili akaweze kushika, kile ambacho hawezi kukipoteza. Praise the name of the living God. Now on that note, on the same note, Paul akatuandikia, akasema ya kwamba, he is ready. He no longer lives. Yani yeye yako totally sold out to Christ. He no longer lives, but Christ lives in him. Praise the name of the living God. Having been a persecutor of the brethren, having been the worst person that that time the believers knew, knowing that this man anatafuta mpaka barua so that he can persecute the believers, so that he can be, I'm sure even Peter, when they used to just hear of Paul, they would run away. Because this guy was a terrorist in the kingdom of God. But the changed Paul, the transformed Paul, became such an instrument in the apostolic ministry, more than even the apostles who are with Christ. Praise the name of the living God. Because when he met with Christ face to face, and Christ told him, "It is I, Jesus, that you are persecuting." Then he got a revelation that, hey, I need to arise. I need to leave this business. Being a commander, being the murderer, being the bad person, and now start propagating that gospel. The same gospel that I was opposed to. The same gospel that I didn't want to hear. The same people that I have been insulting and assaulting and killing are the same people I'm going to defend from now on. Praise the name of the living God. He had to abandon his title in the army so that he could allow Christ to live through him, to work through him. That is why he could confidently say that it is no longer I that lives, but Christ lives in me. And surely we see, as we read through the scriptures, through the many letters that he wrote to the church, even the churches, that he was not just even ready to be assaulted, he was ready to be killed for this same gospel. Praise the name of the living God. He was ready to die. But how many of us are ready? How many of us? I was watching news sometimes back when we had so many terrorist attacks, and Garissa University was one of the places where the attack happened in the university, and we were shown the students who had gone for morning glory, and when these guys came, the Al-Shabaab guys came, they got these people together. They told them, if you are ready to denounce Christ, come this side. If you are ready to die for that same Christ, come this side. And we saw and heard so many of them were killed. So many were martyred because of fellowshipping, because of just being together. Pray honestly to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. How many are ready? The Antichrist are already here with us. How many are ready to say, even if I'm going to die, I die with Christ. I'll be on the Lord's side and not on this other side, to enjoy short-lived pleasures of this world and lose my life. Christ is asking us here in the book of Matthew 16, what is the benefit of one gaining everything at the expense of their souls? Praise the name of the living God. Remember, all these things shall pass away, but the word of God shall remain. Whatever is born of God overcomes the world, even our faith. Praise the name of the living God. And it is a time to soul search ourselves. It is a time to count. Have I invested enough? Nimefanya ya kutosha. Nabda nimemaliza siku 21. A fasting and prayer. Is it enough? Am I going to relax and say like that, rich man who after harvesting his shepherd? That night he said, I can imagine how he was touching his stomach and maybe he had a airport. And now it is time for me to enjoy. I'll just enlarge my pants. I'll just sit, relax, and enjoy my harvest. And then, that night, his soul will be demanded from him. Praise the name of the living God. Ni wakati ambapo, tunarelax, tunarara kidogo, naye Mungu Shetani, anapata nafasi. Eh? Anakuja, anapanda magugu. Baada ya all the doors of misery, all the doors of witchcraft, all the doors of, and the stronghold that by the grace of God we have broken, then it is very easy for us to relax and say, now I am free. Now even my inheritance has been released. Then we relax and the next minute we find ourselves in a bad place. Worse than where we were. Brethren, I just want to encourage us to continue. Do not relax. The cost that Christ paid for us is too high. And in this world, God is ready. In fact, he says that we should not be afraid. Do not fear, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Ni mapenzi ya Baba yetu kutupa ufalme. Na tukipewa huu ufalme, tunajua kama jinsi maandiko yanatuambia, the kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violence taken by force. So, don't relax, my brother, my sister, take it by force. The devil will not just allow us to just have a field day, to just enjoy. And that is why even the children of Israel, when they go to Canaan, the Lord did not just chase everyone else and just let them occupy. In fact, told them before they occupy that I will drive them slowly by slowly by slowly, so that the wrath that does not overwhelm you, so that the wild animals don't come and start devouring you. And also, even after they had been allotted their inheritance by Joshua, there were still others that were left, the Jebusites. They became their servants. They used to carry their water, they used to do all the work there. But also, they used, when the Israelites would relax and start enjoying and forget their God and the covenant that God had made with them, they are the ones who would awaken them. Wanawachapa na wanyorosha vizuri. Praise the name of the living God. So, even us, and that is why when you are born again, God does not chase away Satan from you. Otherwise, the moment we became born again, Shetani akakukwa na apelekwe kuzimu. Matako hapa tuna sisi. Na wakati aliteremshwa, alifukuzwa mbinguni. The Bible says, alikuja na a host of angels. Ako na wafuasi, shetani. Are we ready to cover our bodies to be used by the enemy or by God? What vessel are we? It is a cost. Hata kufuata shetani, kuna gharama. Kufuata Yesu, kuna gharama. Tuko tayari kulipa gharama gani? Praise the name of the living God. The book of 1 Peter, let us quickly go there. The book of 1 Peter. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. 1 Peter 2, 24, the Bible says, praise the name of the living God, 1 Peter 2, 24, he personally carried away our sins in his own body on the cross, so we can be dead to sin and live for what is right. You have been healed by his wounds. New King James put it even better. Who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sin, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes we are healed. So, as we continue counting the cost, he himself, Christ himself, he was nailed on the cross, and through his nailing on the cross, we have received salvation. And the same body that through whom we were redeemed, we also have the healing of our bodies. So the Christ dying on the cross is not just for one benefit for us. It is for multiple benefits. And that is why the grace of God is not one-sided. The grace of God is multiple. And that is why when he was sending Moses and to deliver the children of Israel from slavery, he could not define himself. He could not say, I am just this side. Because he knew if he would only define himself in one way, then it would show that he's limited to only this. Like my sister is a tailor. And if I took a shoe to her to make for me, or to repair for me, she may not be able to do it because she's limited. Yeah? A barber, unless it is trained for maybe to be a tailor, they cannot make clothes for people. They cannot even repair even their own. And so, the grace is normally sufficient at whatever situation. Praise the name of the living God. There are people who are in a certain situation and God delights in giving them the grace to overcome that certain challenge. The other person is going through a certain challenge or a certain season, and God has to manifest himself in that situation also. So his grace is multifaceted. And that is why, as we count the cost of following Christ, as I have explained, there are conditions for me to walk with my brother Boni. We have to agree. There has to be some kind of agreement. Otherwise, we cannot walk together. And that is the one. Maybe quickly we can look at some of the conditions They are not exhaustive. They are just a few of them. Maybe I have no two for now. And trust God for the next session by His grace, enabling us to continue. The first condition, as we have read, is put aside selfish ambition. Ili tufuate Yesu, kuna kanuni, kuna masharti ambayo lazima tuyatimize. Na ya kwanza ni kwamba tuweke ambition kando. We put aside selfish ambition. In this kingdom of God, you can't afford to be selfish and succeed. Because Christ Himself, the author and the finisher of our faith, is not selfish. Otherwise, He would not have let Himself to die on the cross for us. So He offered His all. He offered everything that we could. The highest price He offered for us, for you and for me, so that we will die to sin and live for righteousness. So we have to put aside selfish ambitions. Sometimes it will mean our friends, the ones we love very much, if they are not walking in the path of righteousness, if they are not ready to leave what they are doing for the sake of the faith that we profess, then, sorry, we have to part ways. Sometimes it calls for our jobs. We have to leave them so that we can follow Christ. Sometimes, I remember there is a time we were in employment and in a certain company, and the Lord, the Holy Spirit prompted us to leave that job, to quit, and we had nowhere else to go. We knew nothing else. We had no other monies that we had kept somewhere. I had worked for 10 good years in that company. So it is something, a portfolio you build over time. But I was told to leave it. And it was not easy, my brothers, my sisters. But it is the cost. That time I didn't know it was what the cost that Christ, that God wanted me to pay. But I had to leave it. Otherwise, I started becoming very frustrated. And when I finally gave my resignation, my brethren, talk about peace. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding. I started experiencing it that time. I didn't know that it would be like that. In fact, I asked myself, and why didn't God tell me to leave this island? Yeah? So, sometimes you have to leave the comfort of the people you know. Unawacha watu ambao unajua. Unawacha mahali ambapo unajua. Unaenda mahali ambapo hujui na hujulikani. Unapata, like Abraham, God told him, move from your family, leave your parents, leave hata mahali ungegawiwa shamba, wewe uchomoke. Leave all this and go where I will show you. That uncertainty of what if I fail, and I don't know, I think because we are human, we tend to imagine the worst will happen because where we are going, we don't know. Or what God is about to entrust us with, we are not sure whether it will work. Even when we are called to service or to the ministry, sometimes there are so many question marks. Am I sufficient? Will I make it? And what if I fail? What if it is not the right thing? In fact, tumenenewa, lakini we still need confirmation and reconfirmation. Na Mungu niashue, nikienda hivi nitapata. nitapokea. Ati Mungu tusikosane. It happens. It happens so often that I think sometimes God looks at us and is like, hey, my son, I just wish you would know. And that is why Gehazi, at the time that their enemies, he saw them like this, they were coming to his master. Akaona, hey, hapa kimeumani. But the prophet, the servant of God, told his master, who is God, now open his eyes. Fungua macho ya huyu jamani. Aone that them that be with us are more than those that are against us. So that is what God desires for us, to trust, fully trust in him, and to lay aside most of those things, most of those worries, most of what we care so much about, and leave our cares to him. And which leads me to my next point, is that let God have his way. Condition number two, let God have his way. The cost of following Christ, in counting the cost, let Christ have his way. Let the Lord have his way. Let the Lord have his way. Put your hand in his hands and let him lead. Look above and see the Lord. He'll clear the way for you. Let the Lord, so let the Lord have his way. Let the Lord have his way. Watch a boy, I'll take it here. We cannot lead ourselves. Brethren, in this journey, in this kingdom, who is it yongoza? You can't. I can't. That is why Jesus said that in the book of John, that without me, you can do nothing. Without him, the author, the finisher of our faith, we can do nothing. Our human effort is nothing. Hata tuamke asubuhi mapema. Hata tulale tumechelewa. Kwa kujitahidi kwetu, hatuwezi fikia preciousness ya Mungu. Kwa sababu haki ya Mungu si kama haki ya mwanadamu. Our own preciousness, the Bible says, it is like filthy rags before him. So, let us allow God to have his way. Huwezi shika Mungu huku na ushike ilisi huku na useme utatoboa. Huwezi shika bibi yako bibi na ushike Mungu pande hii kile na kuendeshani. Let God have his way. And that is why everyone, including us who are here and some who are watching us, when we had an encounter with God, even when we read the word of God, when somebody has an encounter with God, then they are changed. They have more. They yield more. We see, even so, for example, when he had an encounter with God, what happened? He stopped being a murderer, a persecutor, and became an evangelist. When Isaiah had encounter with God, he was transformed to be the prophet, the mouthpiece of God that God used. That when they asked in heaven, who shall we say? Isaiah boldly said, I am here, send me Lord. That is after his mouth was cleansed. So allow God to have his way. Allow God to mold you and me into the person, into the vessel that pleases him. Praise the name of the Lord. chose for us. Unapata, unamwambia shule utaenda mahali fulani. Chakula, utakula hiki. College, utafanya hii course. Mimi naona, hakuna daktari kwetu, fanya udaktari. Many decisions were made for us. And not all of them have made us to be the people even ourselves admire to be. No, very few of them maybe have made us what God desires us to be. But when we allow God and let him have his way in our lives, then he molds us and he decides our moves. He instructs us. The Bible says, I will instruct you in the way you should go. And he also says that I will lead you into the paths of righteousness. Yeye peke yake ndiye anatuongoza katika njia za haki kwa ajili ya jina lake. Na kwa hivyo hakuna kitu ambacho ama maamuzi ambayo Mungu atatuelekeza kufanya kama haitamfaidi ama kama si makusudi yake kwa manufaa yetu. Kwa hivyo tunapata ni yeye tu ako na our best interest at heart. Praise the name of the living God. And so as we count the cost of following him, as we count the cost of our decisions in this life, let us embrace his sole decision. Because we can be having many business ideas. We can be having many courses or many things we want to pursue in this life, even for our brighter future. But if God is not the center of it, if Christ is not the center of it, then we are about to fail. We will lose everything. I was listening to one of my friends, and she was sharing with me that before I decided to get deeper in the things of God, I was very comfortable. I had a nice life. I had everything I ever wanted to have in this life. But the moment I went deeper, the moment I decided now I want not to stay far from this God, the spiritual matters, then I think I lost everything. But when I look at the cost of going back, then I think I just stick with this Jesus. Maybe you remember me. It was I can say it was a sad moment for me. I could not say anything at that time. Because it is not easy to convince somebody at such a time. It is a low moment and we are human. But when we read Isaiah 35 verse 3, it is Christ who strengthens our feebleness. He is the lifter of our drooping heads. He lifts us. He is there. He is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. Na wakati tumekubali hii gharama kuilipa, tunajua sisi tunalipa, lakini kwa neema yake ni yeye anatuwezesha. That is why he calls us and he says, you who is thirsty, come to me, come drink. You who have no money, come and buy without money. Yes, even in supermarket where they say free over, you unapata, there is a condition. Terms and conditions apply. Safaricom tells you, do this and this. Tunakupea free bottles. We are giving you free token, but you have to use three quarters of that so that you can get a quarter from me. It is only in his kingdom where he's telling us, you who have no money, come and buy. Without money, come and drink from the river of life. Praise the name of the living God. Hii gharama si nzito, kwa sababu tuko na yule ambaye alilipa yote. Sisi ni kutembea kwa hiyo barabara, ni kufanya kazi kulingana na vile alituandalia kufanya, na hatuko peke yetu. We are not alone. Even as we count the cost and we start now building on the foundation that Christ has laid for us, we are not alone. Let us be encouraged. We have read Matthew chapter 9, verse 28, which is our third point, which is believe. We have already read it from the beginning. Matthew chapter 9, verse 28 to 29, it talks about believing. It's a condition in following Christ. We have to have faith in him. And faith, as we are normally taught, times without number, faith is the currency that we use to purchase things in the kingdom of God. Without faith, we cannot please God. For he who comes to him must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that seek him diligently. Imani ni ya muhimu. Wadugu, hatuwezi chochote bila imani. Kwa sababu sasa utakaaje kwa huu upande? Hauwezi. It's a condition in following Christ, and we see the Matthew chapter 9, verse 28. Also, Christ asking this blind man who came to him for healing, do you believe that I can make you see? Wewe una imani ya kwamba ninaweza kukuponya, ninaweza kufanya uone? Today, the same question. Do you believe that Jesus Christ, the true and the living God, who died and rose up again, is able to handle your issue? Do you believe that in him, that prayer, the prayers that you made for the 21 days he had, and do you believe that he's going to answer them? Even if you have not seen every other miracle that you are believing for, do you still believe that he says what to do immeasurably more than what you ask or even imagine? Do you believe that he's able to save that wayward child and win him for himself? Do you believe that situation that you find like it is a mountain, that he's able to make it plain? Do you believe that he's able to make you that which he promised? That is the question tonight. Unaamini? Unaweza? And this bright man in the book of Matthew said, Lord, ninaamini. The same question, naulizo. The condition, unaamini? Because everybody that Jesus healed, it was because of your faith. Your faith has made you win. Imani yako imekuponya. It is only one man so that he healed through the faith of those who were carrying him. The paralytic man ambaye aliwekwa kwa roof, aliingishwa kwa paa. When the priests who were carrying him saw that the multitude was too much and they could not get access to Jesus, they believed that if only we get him, our friend there, then he's going to receive his healing. And because those guys had faith, they decided to make a way. They decided to remove the roof and let the man down. And because of that, Jesus saw their faith and he healed the paralytic man. Praise the name of the Lord. Do you believe that? Do you believe? Do you believe that your family can be delivered? It is a high time. As we count the cost, we just have to have faith that he who began a good work in us is able, is faithful to take it on to accomplishment. Praise the name of the living God. Let us be on our feet. Our loving Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you and I bless you. I exalt your holy name because you are God and there is none beside you. It is for you who said that for us to be able to follow you, for us to be your disciples, we have to count the cost. Just like that man who wishes to build a tower, they have to sit down and do the estimates. Here we are this evening, Lord. We have heard your word, and you have told us some of the conditions, and we are willing to follow them. Help us, O Lord, not to find it hard to follow you, but through your grace, O God, help us, O Lord, to say yes to you, O God, for it is you who works in us both to do and to will according to your good pleasure. I know that you have not chosen us so that we can perish eternally, O Lord, but that we, by the grace of God and by your mercies, through obedience to your word, that we may inherit your kingdom, O God, and that we may climb even to our high places, O God. I just want to bless you, even as I surrender to you, my brethren, O King of Glory, as we meditate upon this word tonight, O King of Glory, that it shall be lingering in our minds, O my Father, and reminding us what we ought to do at all times, O King of Glory, that we shall not be disqualified at the end of time, O King of Glory, that we shall be welcomed into your kingdom, and without shame for all, you will testify for us before your Father in heaven. We worship you tonight, and we thank you because of this seed, it shall bring forth fruit in 60-fold, in that fold, and even in 100-fold, O King of Glory. That, dear Lord, it shall be our everlasting portion, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Thank you, all of us who are here. May God bless you, our online viewers. Thank you for joining us, and those who will join us later on, I trust that this message shall be a blessing to you, and we shall not just be hearers, but doers of the word of God. I bless the Lord for you. Thank you for taking your time. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and give you peace. In Jesus' name, shalom.